got a riddle for you, Batman. Drive this car out of circles.
Team Joystick Heroes Podcast!
Hey everyone, and welcome to the Team Joystick Heroes Podcast. This week it's Chris,
Rebecca,
Nick,
and Dave.
Wow, we got two guests on this week's podcast, one returning and one a new guy.
New guy. Tell us about yourself.
My name is Dave.
Dave, what do you do on Team Joystick Heroes, Dave?
At this point, I don't really know. I feel like I am in a carousel.
A carousel?
Yeah, I just don't know what's going on anymore at this point.
That's beautiful. Can you tell me more?
First was art, then was programming, then was back to art, then programming, art, programming, art, programming. It's just a pattern.
Yeah, what do you like more?
Personally?
Yeah.
At this point?
Yeah.
Don't really know.
Really?
I was really hoping you say Omega, like third wheel out of nowhere answer.
Oh, speaking of Omega, Omega Team has a new member.
Yay, it's me.
It's Rebecca.
I hate programming. I have so much respect for people that actually program because I don't... There's so much frustration and my computer... I feel like I could have smashed it so many times, but I didn't, so...
You should have done what Shifty does and just get drunk then program.
No, because I feel like that would be worse.
Not everyone can be Bender, though.
Yeah, not everyone, yeah.
Shifty Dave is Bender. He runs off alcohol.
I have yet to do that.
He's like a robot-ish.
That's one thing I really want to do one day, just get uberly drunk and then try to program or do homework.
Maybe it'll work.
Did you see the pictures of his laptop, by the way? Did he show them to you?
Oh, yeah. I was, like, all burnt out
no,
on the inside.
No, oh,
it
no.
Literally looks like he threw it on a bonfire, is what it looks like.
Maybe he did do that. He just doesn't remember it. He's too drunk.
Just kidding. Shifty Dave, we love you.
Wherever you are, getting drunk.
He's probably either at home getting drunk or be at ShopRite.
Yeah, or getting drunk at ShopRite.
No, he does not do that. That's one thing he does not do.
That's good.
So, we actually finally are done with the GDD.
Finally.
Last week we turned it in. Right? On Friday we turned it in. We're recording this on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Also, the first functional prototype.
Yeah. I saw it. It looked like Morrison was having a lot of fun playing it.
He was getting irritated that he couldn't make the one jump. He broke the game, too, because he, like, flipped over, and then he backed up into outer space, and then came crashing down and went over the jump. Like,
it's just one of the features of the game. You can go in outer space.
Well, that was the one thing about having the stupid, I remember watching the cougar car, like, fly off into space.
Oh, yeah, cougars in space.
Cougars in space. I thought that would have been a brilliant game idea had we thought of that one.
It's not even a racing game. You're a cougar in space trying to find love.
Just space racing. Then we wouldn't have to worry about gravity.
No, that's fuck true. That. No, then that's like more. Then we have to program in three-dimensional, not two-dimensional, which
well,
is more
sucks
variable.
For you programmers.
It's actually not as hard as you think it is because we don't have to count for gravity.
True, but then we have to count for the z-axis, and then we have to figure out a key to tilt the object one way.
Yeah, it's not that bad at all. WSD and arrow keys.
Well, Morrison would be bad if we completely change it to a space racing game.
I can't wait to see his reaction.
I think he'd be fine with it, as long
Camden
as we
County
actually
space
do it.
University.
Oh, what?
I'll have to redo the maps, no.
Now we usually on this part of the segment we talk about what we've been playing recently.
What's everyone been playing? Busha, you go first.
I've been playing the beautiful game of all life.
Okay. Anyway.
Life, great graphics, gameplay sucks.
I always have no money in that game.
That's good.
That was the lowest score possible. I've been playing Hearthstone, just try to get in, do my dailies, save up as much gold for the new expansions out, and it's all, like, Lovecraft themed, so I'm like, yeah.
I thought it was all, what do you call it? What's his name?
Well,
Cthulhu.
Well, Lovecraft wrote Cthulhu, so.
Oh, okay.
Lovecraft is the author.
Oh. Did not know that.
What about you, fan?
Myself? No, I'm joking.
What?
been playing with myself. No.
Wait, say it one more time.
I've been playing a lot of FTL lately.
FTL?
Yeah.
It's a fun game to just sit down and play every once in a while.
Because I've been split-screening, like, watching Netflix on one and then, like, FTL or Hearthstone. But I've been playing, like, League of Legends when my friends are on. And, yeah, nothing, really.
Well, I've been playing nothing.
Really?
Absolutely. I've been playing Dice Masters.
Dice Masters.
Dice Masters. That's about it.
Yeah.
As in, but video game-wise, nothing at all. I'm sorry. Sorry, everyone.
This has been a pretty slow week for pretty much all of us. Just not knowing what to do.
Yeah. Speak for yourself. I know what to do. I just don't want to do it.
Huh.
We forgot to mention where we're podcasting right now.
Oh, yeah. We're in Nick Fan's car.
Well, my mom's car, to be exact.
Hey, Nick Fan's mom.
Thanks for letting us podcast in your car.
She will never know about this.
Unless she listens to the podcast.
She barely knows how to internet right now, so she won't.
Oh, she's going to be mad at you when she hears this.
She knows I'm a smartass. I'm not going to lie there.
But yeah, we couldn't get into any rooms to podcast, so now we are podcasting within the confines of a car.
It's pretty nice, though.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not complaining. Really, like, it's a little hot, but other than that...
We cracked some windows. We could probably turn on the air conditioning if it gets way too hot in here, probably.
We really should go for a ride. Like, I'm telling you, we should go to Taco Bell.
I'm pretty sure that's something you can easily get pulled over for. The fact that you can't talk and drive, the fact that we're podcasting and driving...
No, plenty of people.
But for school.
BuzzFeed does this kinds of videos all the time. We can get away with it.
Yeah, but they're on a track, not into, like, the open public areas where accidents can happen. And the fact that I was in an accident yesterday, we're not going to risk it.
All right.
So.
No fun.
What do we want to talk about next?
Can we talk about Geek Fest?
Yeah, we can talk about Geek Fest.
Geek Fest.
Talked about it a little bit last week. I want to talk about it a little bit more since we finally...
Does our viewers know what Geek Fest is?
Well, most of our viewers know our people that we know, so...
But maybe it's one of those many people who liked our page and is listening to this podcast and does not know what Geek Fest is.
Well, Geek Fest is a convention, the only true, like... Comic-Con style convention that was in South Jersey at the time when it was created by our very own game design professor, Ryan Morrison. And he puts it on every semester. He puts it on once in the fall and then puts it on once in the spring.
So twice a year.
Twice a year, yeah. However you want to spin it. And that is, it has a whole bunch of stuff. It has comics. There's games, a lot of vendors.
There's a lot of cosplay, surprisingly.
Yeah, I was surprised. Last Geek Fest, there was quite a bit of cosplay. A little
yeah,
bit more
I didn't
the
think there
one.
Would be that much, but it's. I think it's getting more and more cosplay-y, or I don't know what the word is for, but yeah.
I might have, for when I'm not running the table, I might have my Sans cosplay with me.
Yeah.
Undertale.
Are you going to have like a skeleton face? Or you just
I have a mask that I made that's sitting in my car right now, actually. Well, I didn't make it. My girlfriend made it, but still.
I didn't make it.
Yeah, that's going to be my podcast. Not podcast. That's going to be my cosplay. What about you, Bushtar? Are you going to be cosplaying anyone at Geek Fest?
Nah, sorry.
No. But yeah, Geek Fest. So we'll be there, Team Joystick Heroes, most of us. And we'll be... I mean, by the time this podcast comes out, Geek Fest will have passed.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah,
but yeah.
Yeah. Well, if you see me in my Sans cosplay at any point at Geek Fest, let me know. This will come out afterwards, so just comment. Be like, hey, I saw you in your Sans cosplay, or if anyone else is going to be in cosplay.
If you see a girl with purple hair, short purple hair, might be me.
I was going to say, there's going to be many people with purple hair.
Me and Rebecca are going to be running the table, so we could podcast from the table.
Yeah, we really should.
We're all going to be running the table at one point.
Yeah. Well, we're taking shifts and all. It's just me and Rebecca have first shift.
No, I think he changed it.
Did he?
It's me and Gordon now, and then it's me and Fan at the end, so we're not.
Yeah. Are you excited to be about to be running the table with Gordon?
I'm really excited. He's just going to sit there, and he's going to...
Snark it up.
Yeah, he's going to snark it up, but it's going to be fun.
Yeah, I know I'm on analog game duty through the second shift.
I'm on analog with Logan, which is good because I don't know too much. I know the analog game, but I don't understand all of the rules. I feel like you, Logan, and Nick probably know the most about the analog.
Mm-hmm. Not me, Nick. Other Nick.
Yeah, you're a fan.
Except Annie. Yeah, that it's going to be a long day. It's going to be a pretty busy day. Yeah. I guarantee you there probably is going to be a bigger attendance turnout than Falls Geek Fest just because the weather's going to be a little better.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? Last Geek Fest was beautiful.
Was it?
It was really nice,
but I feel like people go out in the spring. Like in the fall, like people are miserable.
I don't know.
I like the fall, but you know what I mean? It was nice though. It was probably like 40s, I would say. I don't know how it's supposed to be this weekend, though. I didn't look.
Yeah, I'm excited for Geek Fest.
I like Geek Fest a lot. Me too. I'm probably going to buy things.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to buy tons of things.
Tons of things.
Did you buy anything like last Geek Fest?
Yeah, the one guy who owns the shop, All Things Video Games, the one that's right next door to Morrison's Tiki Tiki board games.
He usually sells
a lot of vintage video games, so I usually go there to try to see if, you know, what Final Fantasies he has, because me and my girlfriend are trying to collect them all, or if he has any of the Shin Megami Tensei series of games, because those are hard games to find, so I always check with his shop, and he's usually running deals at Geek Fest.
Yeah.
I picked up Battlefront from him last Geek Fest.
Really?
Like, the original one, yeah.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, his shop's... I saw, when I went to his shop, I don't know, a couple months ago, and they had... He had, like, Soul Calibur action figures.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, my God.
That's
awesome. Like, I've never seen that before.
Yeah,
but
he has some pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, some pretty cool stuff.
I bought, the Avengers versus Ultron Dice Master Stars at last Geek Fest.
That was your first one, right?
Yeah, that's what I bought
at
it.
Now.
I bought it off of Morrison's shop, too.
Wow.
And then I also bought Hawkeye versus Deadpool, all five of the comic books. And I read that.
Yeah.
I'm trying to finish out my Deadpool versus Carnage collection, so maybe there'll be someone with the last two issues of that.
You probably can find the full collection there. I'm looking for that set too.
Did you get anything? Did you go to last Geek Fest, Busha?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Did you get anything?
Nope.
Okay. Moving on.
Good input from Dave Bush to everyone.
Snaps for Dave. So, Dice Masters.
Yeah, we talk about Dice Masters a lot off the podcast, but...
Let's talk about on the podcast.
It's our biggest addiction.
Besides coke, crack. Pretty sure those two are the same thing, I just realized.
They're not the same thing.
Oh, they're not? Oh.
Yeah, you're full. Right.
What? Yeah, we went to a Dice Masters tournament on Saturday.
A big one.
With a whole 20 people.
A whole 20. Was it actually 20?
It was about like 8. No, it was 19 people. Because at the end of it was 19 because the one guy, Tom, dropped out.
Oh, he did drop
out? Why did he drop out?
He had to leave.
Oh, yeah, he did have to leave. I played against Tom. He had a decent team.
Yeah, I played against him my second round, and the bolts just ran him down too fast.
I feel like a lot of people had good decks. Everyone had a good deck. It was just some people knew how to play theirs better. And and me, like, I don't have, like, and then there was, like, an experience, for at least from my part, and I was scared.
Yeah. I mean, I got fifth place.
Snaps.
It was worried. Like, I was worried in my third round. The guy I played against, he had a pretty good team.
I think he ended up coming in first, the guy who you played. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Because he was definitely in the top four, and I think he got first.
But for anyone who doesn't know, we talked about Dice Masters, but we haven't really explained it. It's a dice-building game along the lines. It's a little bit like Magic, except instead of playing with cards, you put cards on the table, and they are your references for what your dice do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's... You roll dice for energy, and you roll dice for characters, and you attack each other with characters. It uses different franchises. It uses Marvel, DC, Yu-Gi-Oh!, and Dungeons & Dragons.
Soon to be Teen Titans 2.
Teen Titans is
no
DC.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
They're technically Marvel, I believe. I believe they're Marvel.
No, they're owned by Nickelodeon. They're their own thing. Yeah.
Huh. Well, it'll be interesting.
That would be interesting. Like, I don't know how... I don't know about Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles so well. I know the four turtles.
Apparently.
And what else?
I was watching the Meltdown, which is a comedy show behind a comic book store. And one of the skits that they did, which was hilarious, was the one was naming different sex positions, while the other was naming different Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle villains. The funny thing is, though, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle villains won.
How many are there?
There's apparently more.
There's I know the one dude. The one, like,
Shredder.
Yeah, and
no,
then
but
who else
there's
there?
Like. There's, like, Beatbox,
made that up, I'm pretty sure.
No. If there's a good amount of villains for the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Not for, like, a whole, like, grab feed type villain.
Do you know how many sex positions there are?
I know, like, that's impressive. Well, it's the ones
There's books on them.
But the thing is, though, the amount of sex position the one guy knew compared to the other guy's knowledge of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles was... Like, the guy who knew more Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles than the other guy knew sex position. It was funny because later on you realize that there was a little girl in the audience, too.
Oh, no.
Trying to explain that to your parents. Like, you know, be like, the parents brought their kid, like, oh, this will be fun. Oh, no, it wasn't. Cover your ears.
If you go on comedycentral.com and look for it's the Meltdown, and it has the title of it is like the one with the little girl in it, because they start off with that, then the one guy talk about the OJ Simpsons, and then the two hosts apologize for the earlier. It's just funny, the whole thing.
I
don't believe that.
Now that you're bringing up Comedy Central, watched all of the first season of Drunk History.
So good.
I watched it actually on Sunday, which was Easter. And
happy Easter, everyone, by the way.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Happy American Easter.
And just that night, my girlfriend put Hulu on, and I put Daily Show just to like see if there was anything funny, and there's usually always something funny. And then I had to go upstairs to take care of something. I came back downstairs. Drunk History was on. And that show is the funniest thing I've ever seen in a while. Because it was just like, my favorite episode was the Wild West episode, where the one dude tells the story about Billy the Kid. It's just like, oh, boom, 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 I'm shooting you, boom, boom, boom. And just... Like, how they get the guest stars. Like, there was one where Dave Grohl, the singer for Foo Fighters and former drummer of Nirvana, is in the episode with Jack Black. And it's the time when Elvis was a narcotics agent for the FBI.
I didn't know that
CIA.
They had guest stars. That's funny.
They have different comedians come on. And it was just really...
Do they know anything about history?
Yeah, they do. They tell the actual story. They just get really drunk. And they
I feel like guest stars, like, do they have the quiz or...
No. They just act. There's with Drunk History, if you've never seen it, it's pretty much like a drunk person telling a story, but it's all in his voice. So you just see the actors, they're just straight up acting, like an old-timey show where there's like no words. They're just doing the motions and like moving their mouth, but it's like all voiced over. I really want, like, one time get really drunk with my friends and do like a Drunk History thing and just have a recorder set up and just tell stupid
things. How do they find these people, though? Do they like go to bars and find historians?
That's my question, because
they're
really
usually celebrities.
Are they?
A few of them are. I know the one guy who did the Chicago episode. Guy who was a writer for the show Blue Mountain State.
So it's kind of like writers and directors where you really don't see the face, but they are considered like famous or in the Showtime business. Okay.
That or they're people that the show knows as well.
That makes sense. Because I always wondered how they got the people. I'm like, they seem very, very intelligent. I just don't know how they, like, where do they go to the bars and They're just like, hey, you like history? Like, I don't understand how they would
tell
find
us a historical event, but first you need to get super drunk.
Yeah, exactly. If someone said that to me, I'd be like, ah.
There's been a few episodes where guys people have just thrown up while they're telling
yeah.
the
story. Oh, yeah, I've seen
that. And then it's because they're throwing up, and then the actor's acting out the part at the sit. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Or they're just like, they start, like, they either mouth it out or something. It's really funny.
This is my question. If you're on drunk history, what historical event would you tell?
Oh.
Well, that's a good question.
I would want to tell the story of Commodore Matthew Perry going over to Japan and forcing them to open their borders. Just because I imagine me getting really drunk and telling that story, acting that out would be hilarious.
What about you, Rebecca?
I don't know. That's either probably Amelia Earhart, because I love her, and I feel like I'd get really passionate when I'm drunk, so I feel like I'd just be screaming about her, how she's still alive. Anyway, that's my theory.
Bushta?
Story of Tokugawa Ieyasu.
What's that about?
He is a samurai from, I believe it was Japan. Basically, very long story.
Fair enough. I'll probably do the Greek and Persian War.
That would be kind of funny to act, have that act out.
Get Jack Black as King Leonidas, too.
Just be like, can I request in this episode that Jack Black play King Leonidas?
Yeah.
Yeah, that show's really funny. I just need to watch season two now.
How many seasons are there?
I think there's either two or three. I didn't watch. We were just Hulu autoplays.
Yeah, yeah.
So we were just autoplaying it, and so after the last episode of the first season, we stopped watching it and mm-hmm. went to bed because it was late. But other than that, what else do we want to talk about? Batman v Superman came out. That's one thing that a lot of people are talking about. We haven't seen it yet.
None of us, I think.
Bush, right? Have you seen it?
Nope.
Okay.
I know I haven't.
I haven't.
Yeah, that's a little polarizing in reviews. I think it got like a 50-something on Rotten Tomatoes.
53. I thought it got like a 30.
I don't like Rotten Tomatoes score because I feel like they always they score things. Like,
they're
overdramatic. Yeah, because I remember, like, Ted, the first Ted movie got terrible reviews, but it was actually a funny movie, but people thought it was, like, a kid movie because it involves a teddy bear. No, it's rated R for a reason, because it's smoke pot, drugs, and all that. Whoops.
Whoops. This is the same thing with Deadpool. Deadpool got a pretty good score on Rotten Tomatoes, I think.
Yeah.
It got, like, around an 80 or something.
Yeah, I think so.
Which is pretty good for a movie like that.
Yeah, they did a really good job making the Deadpool movie, that's for sure.
Yeah, they definitely did.
Yeah.
They stayed true with the comics. Oh, by the way, comics, did you finish my comic books?
Yes.
Do you
we
have
can talk about this off podcast, sir.
Fair enough.
And so Batman v Superman came out, and a lot of people are like, it's too grim, it's too dark. A lot of the reviews I've heard about it is people comparing it to the Marvel movies and saying, it's not like the Marvel movies where they're fun and quirky. And I'm just like, they don't have to be, because a lot of DC comics tend to be a little on the darker side.
Yeah, and
most of them are. Like, I don't... Like, Batman is super depressing.
Yeah,
because it's Batman.
It's Batman.
I mean, you can see what happens with Batman and Robin when you want to try to make a funny Batman movie.
Look at Adam West.
I mean, that's... I still don't think they were entirely serious when they were making that
definitely
Adam West bat. I think they were just like, let's take this thing and just run with bat puns. And they're just like,
is that what you want, people? Do you want another Batman and Robin? Some people, like my girlfriend, that's her favorite Batman.
Really?
I
want to destroy every copy of that movie. No, no.
Really?
Man. Yeah.
It's terrible, but, like, it's funny.
The only good thing out of it is Arnold Schwarzenegger's ice puns.
Dude, that's, like, my favorite old Batman movie. That's, like, the one I watch, like, over and over again.
Wow.
My favorite's the original. The one with Jack Nicholson as the Joker. That
yes.
movie is
oh,
so
yeah,
good.
Yeah.
That one's good, too.
That one is good.
But, you know, like... with a story like Man of Steel and Batman v Superman, you can't really go with this, like, fun, like, hey, everyone's throwing one-liners thing.
No,
you know?
Yeah, that's not... A, that's not Batman. B, that's... I guess, is that Superman?
No, Superman is the blue Boy Scout. He's all serious all the time. He doesn't really joke. If anything,
no.
go... like, at least the Justice League cartoons had it right, where it was more like the dialogue between the characters, because they had known each other for a while.
Yeah.
Batman and Superman were friends, like, old friends. Like, the three, the founding members of the Justice League were all really close.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, they're all, like, you know, the first series, the Justice League series, it took a while for everyone to be on good terms with each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then as the movies, as the show progressed, I mean to say show, not movies, as the show progressed, then all the characters, you know, had good dialogue between each other. Mm-hmm.
Right.
I was watching the Justice League Unlimited cartoon on Netflix a while ago. Really good. I've forgotten how good that show was.
I've been watching Young Justice.
That's really good.
Yeah, it is really good.
I watched it when the second season went up on Netflix. I watched it for about the fifth or sixth time.
Wow.
I'm going to watch that show and rate it on as high as I can, so Netflix will make a third season.
You realize you only get one rating per show, unless you're gonna make multiple accounts. That costs money.
Mm-hmm.
Money that I don't have. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, my friend told me, he's like, watch it, because I want a third season, and if people watch a second, they'll make a third one. So I was like, alright, and he kept bugging me about it, now I'm actually watching it, I'm like, it's pretty good.
I watched the first season, binge-watched that, and then as soon as the second, I knew there was a second season, because I actually saw some of the episodes when it was on TV, and then I just immediately binge-watched the second season. Good.
I like the I think I like the second season a little bit more than the first season.
Because they introduce so much more characters in the DC universe. They also, in the second season, they reference, like, the Teen Titans. I know at one point, instead of Robin, they added Nightwing, and then they added the third Robin?
Yeah, the third Robin is Tim Drake, and he was the one that was,
Batman's son.
No.
He was killed.
Damian Wayne is Batman's son.
Tim was killed, right?
So wait, that's the second.
Who's the Robin that Joker killed?
That was Jason Todd.
Jason
Todd was the second.
There's
Robin.
Like 12 Robins, okay?
There were
5 canon Robins. There was one that's not canon, who's actually a lot of people's favorites.
Who's one that's not canon?
Carrie Kelly. She was the in the Dark Knight Returns storyline, written by Frank Miller.
I see. I feel like a Robin has to be a boy, and if it's a girl, she'd been Batgirl.
There was a female. There was another female Robin. It was Stephanie Brown.
Is there like 2 female Robins?
Well, that's what I was saying. Carrie Kelly and then Stephanie Brown was Tim Drake's girlfriend, who became Robin for a short period of time.
Interesting. There's a Batwoman, but has nothing to do with Batman, and she's a lesbian.
Yeah.
Which is crazy.
What?
Yeah. You didn't know that?
No.
Yeah. She. Okay. So. Do you want to take over the Batwoman thing?
No, you do.
All right. Batwoman's actually really, like, a really cool character, and so I've read a lot of her stuff. She was actually in the newest Batman DC animated movie.
Oh, really?
The Batman Bad Blood movie.
I just like her because she's a lesbian, and she has nothing to do with Batman. Like, it's funny because you would think there would be some correlation,
The reason she took up the Batwoman persona was because she just figured, hey, I'm in Gotham, I'm going to be a vigilante hero, let's just be a Bat character.
Really?
Like, literally, that was her only reasoning for being Batwoman.
So pretty much, like, oh, hey, there's Batman, why isn't there a Batwoman, pretty much?
I like it. Sassy, it's like, take that, Batman, why can't there be a Batwoman?
Is she similar to, is she just a female version? Of Batman, or
no,
she has
guns. She doesn't care.
Exactly. She's so sassy.
Actually, I think I might have to buy that DC comic then. Go off the Marvel train.
She's an old friend of Dick Grayson as well, the first Robin.
Oh, I see.
Probably my favorite.
And
Robin.
Her current girlfriend is what's her name from the police department? She was in Gotham. She was the character that was always trying to take Jim Gordon down in the first season of Gotham. The one detective that also was dating Barbara in Gotham. You know who I'm talking about, at least, right, Finn?
I think so.
Yeah, it's that character.
I just can't think of...
Wait, is she blonde?
No, her...
I only watched a few episodes of Gotham, so I don't really know.
Gotham's... I don't know how well it is to the comic books. I just know it's a really good...
really not.
That's
own
why
series.
I don't like it, because it's so, like... The age difference also doesn't make any sense. Like, you know what I mean?
Selina Kyle and Bruce Wayne being, like, pretty close in age, whereas she's actually younger than Bruce Wayne.
Yeah, like
the
timeline,
Whereas this one, I think she's older than him in the
show. See, I would have gotten, like, the same age.
They're close in age. I just think it's a few years difference in the comics, at least. I think it's a little bit bigger of a difference.
Mm-hmm. But also with the villains, too. Because, like, Mr. Freeze is, like, the time Bruce Wayne becomes Batman, he's going to be, like, almost a
He's going to be, like, 60. He's going to be, like, 60 years old.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense.
I think it's more like this is... there's a lot of things that are, you know, showing that, you know, eventually Bruce Wayne will become Batman. But I think a lot of this is more like, what if there wasn't a Batman when all these villains started to appear in Gotham? Because that's the thing that was explored in Batman, was what if there was no Batman, would all these supervillains still appear?
Would they?
That was a big question, so that's what I think they're trying to explore with Gotham, at least a little bit.
See, to me, I'm getting more like, what if Detective Gordon becomes Batman?
Because that's he is Batman right now.
Yeah, I know, that's what, no, I'm talking about Gotham. That's what it seems like. He's doing his own thing to get justice right, but, like, he actually works for the police, so he has to, his ice is a lot thinner than Batman, because Batman can just run away at the end, while he has to stay there and take the shit. In a sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is kind of, it's kind of like what they're showing in season two.
Yeah, a lot of Gordon's decisions in the first season are coming back to bite him in the butt, at least from what
actually,
I've seen.
Earlier
also in the second season.
Yeah, it's more second season. Because there's not so much from the first season into the second season, except for maybe a little bit of stuff with the Penguin, but that's about it.
What do you think, Bushta? Hmm? Any comments? What's your... Do you read comics?
Used to a long time ago.
Yeah.
Ran out of time.
Yeah. What did you read?
Iron Man.
Really?
Really?
Long time ago.
There you go.
What was your favorite Iron Man storyline or arc?
Been like years. I can't remember most of any of it really.
Fair enough. Which ones that you do remember?
Not much. All I know is that one of them he was rather drunk.
Well, that's pretty much all of them.
No, I think, is that the one when he goes on, like, the self-destructing path?
Nope, not there yet.
Not that one?
Nope.
All right.
Yeah, the one where he's really drunk, that's pretty much all of them, right?
Well, no, there's one where he's, like, full-pledge alcoholic.
What?
Don't pretend you didn't say
Dave
that.
Said it. Dave.
Where he's, like, a full-pledge alcoholic and he really needs help. Type thing. It's yeah.
Yep. So that was Dave, everyone. 30 seconds from Dave.
I feel like we just need to check out, make sure he has a pulse and everything while we're on the podcast.
I'm giving him oil right now. Make sure he's not, because he's a robot. Yep.
One thing that was brought up to me recently, said by someone I know, that they're not a fan of all the comic. They're like, there's too much comic book movies and shows and everything.
That's
now.
What my one friend says. And
I don't know how to feel about that, because, like, there's good ones. There's Daredevil. There's Jessica Jones.
Jessica. I love Jessica Jones.
There's The Flash. Arrow was not that great to start out with, but it's gotten so much better in this, especially in this season.
Like, how bad is it to begin with?
Honestly, I feel like it's the other way around. I feel like it was so better in the first, like, especially the best season so far is season two. All
right.
In my opinion.
Season two, at least, the Deathstroke part. Because I'm a big Deathstroke fan.
Same.
But my only thing is, the first season was way too drama heavy. It was way too much like, which character's sleeping with this character this week.
That's what I've heard, and I don't care about that. I want to watch it because it's a superhero thing, you know what I mean? Like,
It's only the first season, if you manage.
Is it really only the first season?
Yeah,
to be honest,
it's the first. It's okay. So it's pretty much all the first season, a little bit of the second season, and then the third season and onwards. It's more about just developing
superheroes.
It's more about superheroes, but also developing the individual relationships within everyone on the team.
True.
So it's like, you know, now they're all established, working together. They have a system. They maybe have two more characters join in. But now it's all them dealing with, you know, the decisions they make and everything.
Right.
So it's more personal than
it
was in the first two seasons.
Okay.
But yeah, if you can get through the first season, I will say definitely the second season is worth a watch. The third season kind of falls off a little bit towards the middle and kind of like gets really okay. You're like, okay, come on, get going.
Yeah.
And then the fourth season so far has been excellent. It's introduced Damian Dark as the villain, who's a kind of obscure character from the comics. So the fact that they're pulling this character out,
yeah,
and introducing Hive and all this stuff, and yeah, you're like, sweet. So yeah,
cool.
I know, I really like the second season of Flash.
Flash's second season's outstanding.
Amazing.
So far.
Did you see the current episode?
Did they start up again this week?
They started off like last week.
Did they?
They show who, they check Hulu. They show who Zoom is.
Oh, that was the end of. That was before they took the month off. Though to know. Who
no,
Zoom
no, no,
is.
No, no, no. But like, Flash know who Zoom is.
Oh.
Yeah, and they incorporated a lady speedster too.
Really?
In the new episode, and that's like the newest episode.
Okay, so I gotta go home and watch that now.
Yeah, it's interesting.
There's a new episode tonight, then.
Yeah, also. There is, actually.
It's Tuesday, so Flash Nights.
Yeah, there's also Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Has that been any good? I stopped after the first season, because the second season started, and I didn't know if it was going to be as good as the first season was.
Second season, the primary focus was Inhumans.
Yeah, which is basically the Marvel Cinematic Universe's X-Men, because they can't really...
Yeah, yeah, I know, and that's I'm just waiting for them to, like, kill off the X-Men and change their name to Inhumans, and so they Marvel has the cinematic rights. This season, it's focused a lot on... who's that monster thing?
Parallax? No, that's DC.
Yeah, fuck you. No, like, this weird tentacle... Like, it's pretty much, like...
Cthulhu.
It's pretty much like what Hydra was solely based on was on this one monster.
I had heard about that. It was like what Hydra originally was there for, to summon this dude or whatever.
Yeah, and that's what they're tapping into, which is really interesting, because they're focusing more on, well, we know what S.H.I.E.L.D. passes, because it's pretty much Captain America, and then he pretty much built S.H.I.E.L.D. before he gets frozen, and then his girlfriend was like one of the first founding managers. But then what's Hydra's past? And you realize that's going on, like, back into, like, medieval times and stuff. That's
pretty cool.
Really cool.
Because, you know, all you knew about Hydra beforehand was that they were just an offshoot of the Nazi... They were scientific and occult offshoot of the Nazi regime.
Yeah,
so.
There's Red Scar... Bizarro?
No, Baron Zemo.
That's who it is. I think it started with a B and has a Z in it.
Bazinga.
Bazinga. But yeah, we're in a weird time of, like, a lot of these shows and movies coming out are pretty good, but some of them, some people aren't gonna like, and that's just how it's gonna
happen.
That's
how, like, my best friend's like, I'm so tired of the superhero thing, because it's, like, always superhero. I'm like, yeah, but if you're not a comic book nerd, like, I'm always excited, because I'm a huge comic book nerd, and I'm like, oh boy, references.
I feel
to
like it's
other-
getting more people into comics, like, definitely me, it's gotten more into comics. It's gotten-
yeah.
My girlfriend into comics so much more. Like, she watches S.H.I.E.L.D. and all that good stuff, but she's getting into it more, and I feel like it's a good thing and a bad thing. Bad thing because I feel like they're just running out of ideas, and they're just trying to add, like, more superhero movies to the mix.
Yeah.
And they're not really focusing on quality. It's more quantity.
Well, I feel like DC is trying to play catch up now with Marvel.
Yeah.
Yeah, they didn't really jump on the train. The thing that DC has over Marvel is that they definitely have a better animated universe.
I agree. The DC anime... But the thing is, though, I feel like Marvel has a better movies. Not because of the quirkiness, because of the storyline and how they involve. Like, I feel like DC was like, we need to catch up with Marvel. Let's make Batman versus Superman.
Yeah, and they just rushed it, I feel like. If they spent more time onto it, it could have been a great
thing. Or maybe not made so many Batmans and Superman movies and make a Wonder Woman movie or Aquaman.
Well, they are.
Now they are.
Yeah.
But like, now it's like, well, times that out, you're going to have, what, when's the Wonder Woman movie supposed to come out?
I don't know. Next year or in 2 years, I think it's set to come out.
Yeah.
Yeah, by then, you're going to have... The winners, Captain America Civil War Part 2 will be out. Like,
are they splitting it into two movies?
I thought they were.
I don't think so.
I hope they don't.
They need to, because there's no way they can fit everything that's part of the Civil War into one movie.
I heard that the ending is really,
as long as
crazy.
They don't make the ending like a cliffhanger or anything like that.
Well, the ending, spoiler alerts, but if you read the comics.
Wait, don't say anything.
The comics have been out for like
years. The comics have been out.
I don't care. Don't say anything.
I'm here. Well, everyone knows who dies.
Oh, I know who dies.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so everyone knows Captain America dies at the end of the Civil War.
Wait, I didn't know that. I'm just kidding.
Yeah,
the thing is, though.
Who is it that shoots him in the comics?
It was
someone that he knew.
It was Crossbones.
It was Crossbone?
I think it was Crossbones. I want to say Crossbones. I remember watching the video. I want to say Crossbones. I'm not 100% sure. Don't quote me on this. But what I'm excited about is they're making the comic books they're coming out with Civil War 2.
Yeah, with Captain Marvel.
It was Captain Marvel versus Iron Man. And it's also like War Machine's not on Iron Man's side. He's on the other side. There's two different Captain Americas and they're on either side. Like, that's...
Yeah.
Is it going to be the Sam Wilson Captain America?
Is that one in the Steve... is it Sam Wilson? I don't remember who it was. I remember... It was all in the Nerdist. I read this and I was like, Captain America, this Wilson. Like, it had the names lined up and I'm like, holy smokes.
I think the comics come out in summer.
Yeah,
I might have to read them then because I liked the Civil War storyline. I bought the full graphic novel for the Civil War storyline. The only things that's missing are like the few like individual issues where like, you know, there's more like of Reed Richards dealing with other people. Those are the ones I don't have, and maybe I'll try to find like compilations of that stuff, but
isn't it like 7 or 9 books?
I think it's nine books that compile the Civil War graphic novel.
Yeah, because I know I saw it on Amazon and I have it on my wish list. I'm like, I really want to buy that, but it's like $100 for the full set. I'm like, do I just drop the $100 or do I save the $100 for maybe a graph feed? Like,
so many
choices.
Yeah.
I wanted to talk a little bit about anime at least for the podcast. Because I've been watching quite a bit of anime.
You can talk. It's okay.
This is a safe place. We can talk now. I've just finished up this. It was a show called Gate. It was really interesting. If you have Crunchyroll or anything, or it's on Hulu as well.
It's on Funimation. Because I have Funimation subscription. I have not used it at all.
It's not dubbed yet, so I'm not too sure.
Okay.
It's a show like, it's in Japan. This gate to like a fantasy world opens up and this army comes through and invades, but this is in modern day Japan. So then the Japanese self-defense force goes through the gate after the initial attack, captures a hill, and it's modern weaponry versus like medieval fantasy weaponry. And so it's just legions of dudes with shields and spears getting mowed down by full assault rifles. Aww. And it's like, they're trying to get peace, but there's people who don't want peace. Like, the JSDF wants peace, but there's people in the fantasy world who don't want peace.
Okay.
It's just a really good show. It's a lot of fun. The characters are really well-developed, and it was a really fun show to watch. Other than that, I've been watching a whole lot of Fairy Tale.
Is that still going on?
Yes, it is. We're on the last 2 arcs in the manga, the last arc in the manga, and then the anime has about 2 arcs to catch up, and then that'll finish out.
The only reason why I really like Fairy Tail is because the show and the book that got me into, I guess, anime and manga was Rave Masters.
Rave Master was really good.
That was the first book I buy, and that's the first one when I realized, this is not cartoons, this is anime. Even though I was watching Dragon Ball Z, Pokemon, Gundam, all the older ones, but to me that was always this is Dragon Ball Z, 2-2s are fighting, that's awesome, there's explosion in the background, not affiliated with anime, but
now you know what anime is, and you know, the same with me, the first time I realized I was watching an anime, it had to have been Bleach, actually. When I was full on because Naruto had been on Toonami and Adult Swim for the longest time,
right.
And I had been watching it, and I just hadn't caught on. This was before I knew what anime and manga were, and I'm like, oh, after Bleach and everything, after I got into middle school and Bleach started up, and Death Note. Death Note was another gateway series, because I remember when the first episode of that aired on Adult Swim, and it aired about three times that whole night, and I was at my friend's house and watched it those three times. But that was my first experience. This is like when I first realized, oh, this is anime. I've been watching anime all my life. You know, going home watching Gundam on Toonami.
Dude, yes.
And all those, and Dragon Ball Z. I would always rush home to watch Pokemon and Dragon Ball Z as they aired.
I agree. I remember Pokemon came on, I think, at 4 o'clock, and then Yu-Gi-Oh! Came on at 4:30.
Oh, Yu-Gi-Oh! Yu-Gi-Oh! was another one. You're like, that's an anime, too. Yeah.
Well, at least I think the older ones were. Like
they're all still anime.
Yeah. Oh, they still?
They're all still made in Japan. Okay. Yes, Pokemon still.
The Yu-Gi-Oh! Manga is actually really...
Dark,
yeah, because I had a subscription to Shonen Jump. That's how I kind of got into manga and anime, and I would read the Yu-Gi-Oh! Manga and be like, this is scary. Like, I'm going to go watch the show now and make myself feel a little better. People, like, die, and it's, like, crazy stuff.
Yeah, a lot of the manga is, the first few chapters of the manga have nothing to do with duel monsters at all.
Mm.
It's
really?
All yeah, yeah, it's literally what it is it's Yugi gets in a situation that the Pharaoh then, like, it's usually involving some kind of person that's causing a problem. Like, the first one is a bully who then decides to play a punishment game where it's like you pull cards or something.
I remember that.
And the loser would, and then if you lost, something happened. Well, then the Pharaoh decided that, and the Pharaoh made the bully see leaves coming off of the tree as money. So then he was thinking he was rich.
Yeah.
And it was just stuff like that. There's a part where Mokuba tries to steal the Millennium Puzzle or something.
Yeah.
And he gets messed up by the Pharaoh. It was really dark. And even past, once it's all about duel monsters in the manga, there's still, like, when Bandit Keith cheats playing against Joey, he gets... Pegasus puts him through a punishment game that he almost loses his mind from.
Yeah.
And stuff like that.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's nothing like the show.
Yeah, it's really good, but it's just... It's such a switch from the show to the manga.
Yeah, that's a really big difference, is that dark... That level of darkness between the two.
What about you, Dave?
Hmm?
Any anime you're watching?
Recently... Nothing that I can remember the name of right at the moment.
What was it about?
It's really weird. Involve alternate universes, and every universe just got worse and worse.
Was it Bioshock Infinite?
No.
Was it the one episode of Space Dandy?
No.
Oh, yes. Space Dandy was so good.
It was like the same thing everything was basically the same event, the same days and everything, except each time it was like something different happens. So in one version, the guy goes crazy and murders two girls. Next version, he gets murdered.
Oh, I know which one this is. It's Higurashi.
Is it?
Yeah. It's all like, all the characters are really cutely designed, and it's all about murder. Like, it's a really dark show. It's one of the few actual horror anime, too.
The main character was like, twins in it, right?
Were there twins in it? Yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's the one.
Yeah, it's a really good show. I suggest you watch it, but watch the Japanese, because the English dub is awful.
Very grim.
It's horror?
It is. It's real. It's like, anime can't always do horror right, because anime is, you know, it's not, the people don't look realistic. They're anime characters.
Right.
So there's a level of disbelief, but, so that's a show that's really good on, like, you know, time keeps repeating, but some things are different every time. So it's like slight changes, and it's presented in an interesting way. That if I were to explain it to you, it would spoil most of the show. So.
Okay.
But yeah, I suggest watching it if you get the chance. What about you, Rebecca?
I've been watching Brotherhood, because I never got a chance to watch it back in the day. I watched the original.
Full Metal Alchemist, right?
Yeah. And then now I'm watching Brotherhood, and it's so wonderful. It's heartbreaking in so many ways, and I'm just really excited to see what happens. And they go into so much more storyline than they did with the original, so it's, like, exciting to see, like, what else is going to happen. But, yeah, that's about it.
The original was really confusing. I remember I was a kid watching the ending, of it, and I had no clue what I was watching. Like, I stayed up late because I was watching Ghost in the Shell, and that was a show. As a child, I had no grasp of what Ghost in the Shell was, but now
I still don't understand what it's about.
It's about a lady?
It's about a lady who kicks a lot of butt.
Yep.
That's the most I got from it when I watched it.
Same.
She's like a cyborg, and she kicks butt. That's about it. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of politics in the show that you have to get through.
That's one thing I hate about some shows.
Like Gundam's a lot of politics.
I've been pretty much watching whatever's been on Toonami. Like, the Dimension W is really interesting. Because it's like, what happens if the human... Like, it's... What happens when the human race found the fourth dimension, and pretty much what the fourth dimension is, it's... power. Well, not... Yeah. Power, pretty much. So they came up with these energy things that are coils, which are pretty much batteries, but they like don't run out pretty much, and there's like some illegal ones too, and it's pretty much about this one dude who hates coils and just goes around hunting the illegal coils.
Mm-hmm. Why does he hate coils?
He's just like the old school dude, and like he's really cool because like he drives around like an old car that uses gas while all the other cars are electric power.
Is he like, so he's like an old geezer that hates when kids are on his lawn?
not so much that. He's like I know, in his 30s 40s type characters, but like he's also like kind of like a ninja-ish thing where
he's a ninja.
Pretty much,
this
too.
This is crazy.
Dude, it's a crazy awesome show, because he, like, his weapon of choice are, like, have you ever seen Naruto? Like, those surgical needle things that the one dude throws?
So,
that's his weapon of choice, but they're always on string, so he throws them, takes out robots, and, like, pulls them back to throw them again type thing. It's really cool.
Ow.
It's pretty crazy.
And he has a companion that's a, robot, but like it's more. There's clearly
a girl, perchance.
It is a female.
Has a tail.
Yeah.
Yep. I started watching that.
Dimension W. It's a good show, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but like you can tell there's something more to it. You find out like it's still like the typical anime where there's like this hidden dark secret that you don't know about, but you kind of hint that it's there.
I just remembered something. This season, anime season. Which actually starts up, I think, this weekend, is the next part of Digimon Adventure Tri.
How is that?
It's really good, and as a child who grew up on Digimon...
But it's only on Crunchyroll, isn't it?
It is.
I don't feel like buying...
It's only $7 a month.
Know what else is only $7 a month? Netflix. Know who doesn't have a job but still pays for Netflix? Nick does. So he has to choose between Netflix... or Crunchyroll.
Netflix really isn't that good, though. Once you watch all the shows that you wanted to watch on Netflix, there's nothing more. Yeah.
But the thing is, I haven't gotten to that point yet, though. There are still
you
shows
will,
that...
though. You'll get to it in, like, a week.
Is there ever such a thing where you've watched everything you possibly can on Netflix, and there's just, like, go home. Just, like, go outside. Do something.
Those probably be, like, do you want to rewatch all this stuff?
Like, I'm trying to think. I have rewatched some movies like Hot Wet American Summer Fun.
That was a really funny the movie, and then the show that they put out.
The show was like the show they did perfect.
Wait.
Paul Rudd's really funny in that.
Dude, they're all really funny. The celebrity cast is so large, and it's
the movie's like older, right?
Yeah.
The movie's older, and the funny thing is the series
is
like
a prequel.
It's a prequel.
But all of them, and they're old, right?
Older, playing young selves of themselves. It's just funny. And,
my favorite is the voice of Archer.
It's
the camp counselor. He's, the owner or something.
It's the guy of Bob's Burgers, too.
Yeah, he's Bob's Burgers as well.
That's how I see him. Some people see him as Archer.
I think he went out with season two of that.
Of what?
Hot Wet American Summer Fun, the second day. Because the entire series, what you don't realize... is one day.
It's all one day, so it's like a season of 24 is all within one day.
Yeah.
Each episode is an hour within the day.
Or like a different time within the hour.
Yeah.
Which I don't realize because like the movie's the last day.
That's really funny. I thought that was really funny when I saw that, and I'm like, wait, they're all just older. They're older actors playing younger versions of themselves. That would be like if you did a Star Wars prequel and you cast Carrie Fisher as Leia again, and you're like, no,
oh no, everyone would hate that.
Yeah.
It'd be funny, but
It'd be hysterical.
She would be really funny about it, too.
I think. I think she would have so much fun with it.
She would just be like, look at me, I'm young and hot. and everyone's like, well, wait, Carrie Fisher. And she's like, no, this is me.
Carrie Fisher's so funny.
Have you ever seen, like, her interviews?
I did see one thing. It was like, I think the interviewer asked her, like, oh, would you ever have sex with a Star Wars fan or something like that? And she's like, I have. She's like, they're actually, like, probably the best. She's like, some of them are, like, so enthusiastic. I'm like, oh, my God.
Well, that was, like, the one she was talking to the girl who played Rey in episode 7. And she said, I had a man come up to me and be like, you're Princess Leia. And she's like, yes, I am. And he goes, I thought about you every day. Since from when I was like 12 to you know now, and she's like every day, and he's like twice a day. And she's like, that's what you have to look forward to.
Aww.
And it was just one of those excellent moments where you're like, oh, Carrie Fisher.
Yeah, no, she's funny like that. I like her.
Have you seen the when the actor of Kylo Ren hosted SNL when the Force Awakens?
No, I didn't see that.
It was hilarious because one of the skits, they made fun of Kylo Ren because of his anger issue. It was like undercover boss.
Yeah.
And he's like, and is it him as the undercover boss? And
he's like talking to the other like stormtrooper. He's like, so I hear Kylo Ren has a six pack. And he's like,
so the funny thing is like, they're like, wait a minute, you knew it was Kylo Ren the whole time? Like, I knew it when you said, hello, my name is Matt. Which is, like, the first thing he says when he came, like, it was, like, the first thing when you see him as the undercover employee. He was like, hi, my name is Matt. And then it cuts to the one employee, and I'm like, yeah, I think Matt's Kylo Ren. Most definitely sure.
Yeah.
So, like, all of them are, like,
aware of this,
but not admitting to it, but still being nice. And then, like, he force chokes someone. Like, yeah, I think Matt Kylo Ren. Like, I figured out when he force choked me.
That sounds really funny.
It was probably one of the.
Did you know Daniel Craig is in Star Wars Episode 7?
Did you know Kevin Smith is also in?
Yeah, he was. Which one was he? Was he Traitor?
No, he wasn't a traitor. There's a lot of celebrities that were stormtroopers.
Oh, they were just stormtroopers?
It's not going to be James Bond is in the background. They're
yeah,
like,
that's why I was like, wait a minute.
He like starts like, taking out guys.
No, he was actually the stormtrooper who said, not James, Kevin Smith. He was the one who said, the rebels are coming or something like
that.
Oh,
was it?
Or we found the rebel base or something like that.
Wait, so then did he talk at all?
He was the one that Rey's like uses the Jedi mind trick on. That's Daniel Craig.
Wow, she tricked James Bond.
Yeah, she tricked James Bond.
This is my question. Crazy. What did Star Wars like? Do you mean the Star Wars movie? You be a stormtrooper and you get shit pay, or did they kind of like listen? Can we be in the movie? We'll do it for free. And they were like, sure. By the way, you're being a stormtrooper, and they were like, okay.
I think, in all honesty, was that J.J. Abrams knows a lot of people.
Fair enough.
And he was the director, and he probably had a lot of pull and was just like, hey, did you want to... Or either that, or if it's like, you know, people in the cast are friends with people, and they're like, because cameos happen all the time in movies.
I know that, but, like, that's probably... Like, were they all stormtroopers, or, like, were a lot, like... That's my question. Like, how many celebrities were stormtroopers in that movie? Was there a lot, or was it just like a like 4 or 5?
I think it might have just been like four or five.
That'd
I don't think there
was like a bunch.
Because that'd be crazy if like, oh, by the way, all the stormtroopers are like better actors than the main actors type things.
Hey, the main actors were pretty good.
They were good, but like, think about it. Like, can you imagine like, oh, hey, it was Robert Downey Jr. was the traitor.
Robert Downey, oh, okay. We're not going to get into Robert Downey Jr. right now.
Well, that's like,
we could talk about Robert Downey Jr. off the podcast.
Yeah.
But, like, I thought that, to me, I feel like with Kevin Smith, like, yeah, we're making Star Wars movies. Do you want to be in him? Like, sure, like, you're not getting paid. He was like, I'm completely fine with that. Because, like, the type of person he is, he's just a big nerd.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah. All right. We're coming pretty close to time here. It's almost, we've almost been podcasting for an hour. So.
That's ridiculous. I want to go home.
I
want to eat something.
I had fun, though, talking to you guys.
Our Carcast.
The Carcast.
Carcast.
All right, so
do you want to do the outro again? You can do the outro again.
I'll do the intro.
You start doing the outro.
Okay. This has been a Team Joystick Heroes podcast with Rebecca,
Chris,
Nick,
and Dave.
Bye.
Bye. See you guys next week.